We're going to make some Cherokee wheels on this basket, and I've woven up to the point where they're going to be. And there's two ways you can do this. You can do them at the point, or you need to add them, or you can finish the basket and come back and do it later. We're going to do them right now. And to be prepared for the wheels, you need to have two rows of half inch flat with a row of quarter inch flat oval in the middle. If you're doing a smaller basket, you could do 3/8 rows. And for the wheels, I'm using number 2. On a smaller basket, you could go down to a number 1 round reed. I would not suggest trying a number 3. It would be, unless you have a huge basket, it's going to be too heavy of a weaver. So to start, make sure your weaver, your round reed, is wet and flexible. And I'm going to just lay that behind. Then find the other end. And open up a spot. And I leave my tool in there to keep an opening to make it easier to pull through and pull straight. You don't want to pull up, pull straight. And I'm going to curve that around so I know where it's at. And then just kind of baby it down there. Take that out. And then I've come around the top. And this is going to go over the tail. And I'm going to clip that just to kind of help hold it. Once again, you're going to go basically around in a circle 4 times. After the second time, I'm going to trim that tail, and it'll be caught in. There, it likes to get hung up. Now, after this time around, I'm going to trim this tail. So we have 2 rounds in your wheel. By the third time, you should have some gap there that you should need to leave your tool in there. It's not hard, it just takes time. And now, you see, you don't see the end. This is our 4th round, and then I'll show you how to start the next one. There's 4 on this side, so we need to come on around. Other way. So since you're coming out at the top, the next wheel, you will go down and start underneath. And then you go around the opposite way. And once again, if it's a little tight, use your tool to help hold open a little bit of the gap. That clip is just to keep it from sliding out while you get to your end. The nice part about doing the wheels as you get to them is that you don't have to pull through the top. You just roll it around there, and that puts less strain on your weaver. Okay, this is the fourth one, and then I'm going to show you how this alternates. I'm doing this with space-dyed reed today, so you have some nice color variations in each wheel. Okay, now we have four rounds. Now on the first wheel, we came out of the top and went down. On the next wheel, then it comes out from the bottom, and we're going to go up to the top to start. So you'll see your line goes down and then up, and then it'll go down and up and alternate around. And then I'm going to go back. And start another wheel again. If your end starts getting frayed, just cut it off. You generally need about a half a yard per wheel of weaving material. But at some point we will have to add in. And we'll show that in a little bit. And now here's our, we're going to start on our next wheel. Now we come to a point where we need to add in another weaver. So we have the tail underneath where we normally go, have the new weaver, and I'm going to slide this in. Right here next to it. And they're going to let this new weaver come up and go over the old tail. We're going to just leave those tails for a few rounds. After we get a few rounds in, we can tighten it down and then we're going to trim these ends. Now I'll trim both ends. Tighten everything down. And then continue on with your wheel as normal. And then just keep going. We've now come around the basket doing our wheels, and we've finished the last one. So to hide the end and be complete, all you do is kind of lay that up there, kind of see how much you have, and just trim. And then take a tool and you're just going to tuck it up underneath. There you complete your pattern.